Gitandara chimana rekangu.
Hallelujah.
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 Semu hii Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
This place. Yes sir.
Bado. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Kunyosha na mikono sema
amen.
Amen.
Karibuni sana katika neno la Bwana.
Welcome to the word of the Lord.
Fise umurongo umwe ngomba kuhagara lako.
I have one verse that I want to lean on.
Ndagomba kandi ngo unyumvirize.
And I ask that you listen to me.
Ariko ntaravuga.
But before I say,
sinoreka gushimira Imana yo mwijuru.
I cannot stop thanking God in heaven.
Impaye mwanya nkabankiriho mwisi.
Who has enabled me to be on the earth.
Kandi kantera iteka ngo mvuge ijambo ryayo.
And he has allowed me to speak his word.
Sinokuya kandi gushimira akozi b'Imana.
And I also want to thank the leaders.
Bande iteka.
Who have also giving me this opportunity so that I can preach the word of God. And I also want to thank you. I believe you will be silent and you will listen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'd like to tell those that I teach that love me.
Niho ibyo mvuguza kubyumviriza.
It's when you listen to what I'm saying.
Ukabyizera.
And you believe it.
Hanyuma bikazogufasha.
And it will help you.
Nza gusaba abantu babiri bamfashe gusoma.
I'll ask two people to help me read.
Ufite Kiswahili.
The one who has Swahili.
N'uw'Icyongereza.
The English one.
Nanye nasoma Kirundi.
And I'll read in Kirundi.
Numurongo uri muri Matayo gatandatu.
It's a verse in Matthew chapter 6.
Kumurongo wa 33.
From verse 33.
Nibaza ko benshi muzi ku mutwe.
I believe some or many.
Igituma ngomba ko ari batatu basoma.
There is a why I want three people to read this.
Ni nkaho nari kubasaba ngo tufate mu mutwe.
It's as if I was asking you to memorize it in your head.
Lero ko turabana ku bajya batoya.
So because we are not little children.
Ugombye ni wabufata ku mutwe.
The one who wants is the one who memorizes.
Ariko bajya bana batatu batabateka bakabufata bankabemera.
But we command the children to memorize it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And if you grab it as well, it will help you if you memorize it. So the one who saw in Swahili, please read for us. So Matthew chapter 6, verse 31.
33?
Oh, 33.
Yes.
Amen.
Bali mtafuteni kwanza ufalme wake. Na haki yake na haya yote mkazidishiwa. Basi msisumbukie ya kesho.
No, umemaliza mstari mmoja tu.
One verse.
Yeah.
Let's read in English. Yes. So Matthew 6, verse 33. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well.
Ndasoma nanjye. Ariko mubanze mwitwararike ubwami bw'Imana n'ubugororoka kwayo niho ibyo byose muzobyongerwa. Amen.
Amen.
Twese tuvuge ngo amen.
Let's all say amen.
Muri uyu murongo,
in this verse, there is two main words. If you have a pen, you can underline it. The first one says the kingdom of God. The second says righteousness. This is things that you need to put first before everything else. The servant of God that just said, he said about those who seek for the I'm not going to talk about that again. Let me talk about this following thing. The kingdom of God and righteousness of God. The righteousness of God. I will speak to you. I will focus mainly on the kingdom of God. And I tell you what the kingdom of God is. If you want to remember the teaching of today, write the kingdom of God. The last time I was here, that gentleman was the one translating for me. I told you nothing can separate me from the Lord of Jesus Christ. It explained according to how God is living. Now I'll tell you what the kingdom of God is. Because if we do not understand this, you cannot put it first. You cannot seek first the things that you cannot seek first the things you don't understand. So how does righteousness come? Many study the word of God and they stop in the middle. And they say there's no one righteous. Yes, I believe nobody sins. I mean, everybody sins. But I believe there is repentance. That's what we find righteousness. Praise the name of Jesus. Truly they have all sinned. And they fell short of God's grace. But listen. The song that gets that word of God from. He says, in the world nobody's righteous. And then they stop there. Me, I continue.
Kirete.
Except the one who believes. That they have been cleansed by the blood of Jesus. And if you connect it, finish. If you get one part, you think you are in truth, you have no reach there yet. The blood of Jesus cleanses us, and we become holy. That's the door we pass in to get to heaven. And no one will be justified by their works.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ariko kwizera Yesu.
But to believe Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Biramaze.
That's it.
Umwizeye.
The one who believes.
Nibikugora gufukama.
It does not bother you. It umwizeye. You will not be hard for you to ask for forgiveness if you believe him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. There is things that I want to tell you. Even if I don't name them. You know sins more than me even. But I
want to
tell you against sins. There are things that you do yourself individually. You yourself, you need to confess those things. There's sins for the family. Even if you don't do it, and you bring consequences on you, maybe your parents, your mother or father, or your relatives, and you fall in it, and they'll condemn you of it. You need to confess those things. Praise Jesus. I'll give you an example. When somebody in the family steals, and they bring it home, you eat from it when you don't even know the
stolen.
You are among the thieves. When you did not steal, do you understand? Don't say it wasn't me. If you go to repent, if you explain,
because
you haven't confessed your sins, announce your sins, and ask for forgiveness. Don't say it's my wife who made me do it. It's because of my child. There is no, you know, Daniel. You are only explaining yourself so they can, you can justify yourself.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Praise Jesus.
Hari ni cyaha kihanga.
There is another sin of a nation.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Praise Jesus.
Muri komara ntaho.
You understand? And that's what Daniel to pray for his nation.
Utarashikaho hanyuma utakoze.
Before you, until you can get to a point where you confess that you haven't committed.
Unatari has God.
You are still below. I want to move on. So what is the kingdom of God?
Yes.
Jesus, he came teaching. If the same thing as
John,
that he said, repent, for the kingdom of God is near. In other words, they said, repent, because the kingdom of heaven is near. The kingdom of God and the kingdom of heaven is very similar. It's different words, but it means the same thing. Why did I say the kingdom of heaven?
Israel,
the Israelites, they were taught to obey God. They would not say the name of God. But people of nowadays, if they just fall, they say, oh my God. And they are in sin. The Israelites, the name of God, they did not neglect
the name of God.
That's what it's written even in the
book.
Do not say the word of God, do not misuse the name of the Lord God. That's why they say, instead of saying God, say the kingdom of God. And they will say the kingdom of heaven. So the kingdom of heaven and the kingdom of God, when you read it, it means the same.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Tuli kumwe.
Are we together?
Mliko mra nawe.
Are you understanding me?
Mbandani.
Should I continue?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
None ubwami bw'Imana mwebwe bibaza ko ari iki?
So what do you think the kingdom of God is?
Yesu yagenda arigisha.
Jesus went teaching.
Ariko niyademye ku rutoki.
But he did not point it.
Abahinga ba Bibiliya.
The aspects of the Bible or those who study the Bible, they show that the Israelites knew what that word means. So in the teachings of Jesus, he continued. When Jesus was teaching about the kingdom of God, many times he said in parables, if time allows me, I'll reach there. I believe I will be trustworthy on time.
Hallelujah.
But I want to tell you, in one word, we need to understand what the kingdom of God is. Because if we don't understand it, if we do not understand what the kingdom of God is, we will not seek for it. But if you know it, and you want to put it in action, it will be possible. From Exodus, we're not going to read. I want to be quick. You can read so you can write it down so you can read it. Exodus 15, verse 8. He says,
Uhoraho,
the Lord,
azokwama,
will always
ahangamye ibihe bitazoshira.
He will reign forever.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Uhoraho,
the Lord,
he is God.
Izokwama ahangamye, he will remain or reign
ibihe bidashira
forever.
Iganza mwijuru,
he's in charge in heaven.
Iganza kwisi,
he's in charge on the earth.
Nikuzimu,
even under the earth.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ibyo tuzi,
the things we know,
nibyo tutazi,
the things we don't know.
Ibyo tubona,
the things we see,
nibyo tutabona.
And the things we don't see.
Byose ni uganza ubasha bwa.
Everything God is in charge.
Rero ubwami bw'Imana,
therefore the kingdom of God,
ni jambo rimwe,
in one word,
nukuganza kw'Imana.
It's the
kuganza kwima.
The rain.
Do I say that?
The rain. Yes. It's the rain of God.
Don't I misspeak English? Is it Kirundi?
Nah, keep praying in Kirundi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ukuganza kwima.
It's the rain of God.
Ububasha kwima.
So the authority of God.
Iki kintu tugomba kukirondera imbere y'ibindi
byose
nicyo gituma abakurikira
shetani
ni ngombe ngo barabishyurire.
It's as if they understand it.
No, let me get this revelation.
They have received the revelation.
So they do
their
thing
in the power of Satan. And people think it's things of God. You see, God has, I have great
faith.
I can discern the things of God in the
spirit.
Even if I can tell you.
Because
I'm trying. You see, servants of God. They know the strength of God.
And
the stress of demons. Even if they are quiet. You see, those who pray for
demons.
And they will tell you if they have bonus or they are not. Whenever we don't have time to pray for demons. And they remain quiet. And we leave them. Because we don't have time to be here. We don't keep struggling with them. You go home.
Another time they might even get you when we are not
around to pray for you. Knowing that they are in you.
Praise
the name of Jesus. So when they remain quiet, it's not all servants of God who get their time and preach and to
fight
all who stop preaching. So what I want to say is this. Let us understand the kingdom of God so that we can seek for it. The word of God has said, let's first seek the kingdom of God. And his righteousness. And other things will be
in
but people seek first the things they own. But the things kingdom of God, they make a last. But once you understand the things concerning the kingdom of God, truly it's good. Even if you read in Psalm 145,
10 to
35. We're not going to read
at the
same
time.
You see, it will talk about concerning the kingdom of God. And the kingdom of God reigns forever. The kingdom of God will remain forever, as I said. As time will come, the kingdom of God will remain forever. Nothing will be removed.
If you're not to come of Jesus,
I know you believe that.
If
you pray that, your kingdom come. What are you saying? You are saying the leadership of God be allowed so that his will be on earth as it is in heaven. Let me ask you one question. Do you think here the kingdom of God is not
on earth?
The word of God says the kingdom of God is in you, is among you. So how come people don't understand it and they don't see it? The kingdom of God, once you are saved, it will live in you. Amen. From the prayer Jesus taught his disciples to pray, there is the kingdom of God come.
So
you need to pray the kingdom of God come to live in you.
If you go,
so that God's will can be in you. So that God's authority can be in you. If it's not that, if the kingdom of God is not in you, there is another kingdom in you. The other kingdom I'm talking about,
Australia.
It's not the country of Australia.
Suburaya.
We are not talking about the West.
Si Africa.
We are not talking about Europe or Africa. The kingdom, people see this leadership.
Micho cha tu,
that's what caused the
Israelites
to Those who did not understand the kingdom of God, in the times of Jesus, they struggled. The Israelites, they really struggled. Only few understood. Many never understood
it.
They looked for Jesus. They were expecting for Jesus
to be the Messiah,
but they did not accept him or believe him. They thought
he
would be in the politics.
He
would lead all the Israelites. Because he said, I'm the king of the Israelites. So do you know how the king is? But him, he humbled himself.
The,
so as the servant of God said, they stand in the kingdom of God. And he denies the kingdom of
God.
So if they don't see him the way they want him, and then they left him. So us, we are lucky. When they left him, we took him. So we should preach.
Pray
the gospel. We are not Israelites. Praise the Lord. We know our nations. We know. We used to be called Gentiles. But now we are called children of God. I know truly I'm a child of God. Praise the name of Jesus. I'm lucky. My parents called me the
woman.
I belong to God. When I see it, I don't lie, yes, I'm in the earth like other people.
I don't know, I'm a child of God, and then I do this, it's not right, I'm only saying the name, I have not spoken about the spirit, that time I cried.
I shed tears and cried. The servant of God left here and said, it's not joking. I am not putting myself up. For those who know me, I don't joke around.
That's condemnation.
I know for those who know me, I'm not being.
Praise Jesus.
But I'm not righteous. But I believe the word of God. There are some who know me who can testify and say we know him. I feel like I want to go in the
fields
and I enter and I go deep and understand. And then they live in me. So about the kingdom of God, it's needed. As you accept Jesus as the Lord and Savior, the kingdom of God dwells in you. So you need to go according like a child of the king. Like a child of God. All these things that of the world, you need to leave it. There is things of the world that I need. But they should not take, be number one. Including money. It's not the first thing, but it's not the first thing. I haven't even spoken about things that we need on the earth. We need to eat.
No,
and to where we need to
eat.
But they're not important. I'm still on the word. What we should seek for before everything else is the kingdom of God and righteousness. The things that we need physically, even if you don't pray for it, God knows we need those things.
Praise
the Lord. And here I'm almost finished. Now let me go to Proverbs. The parables that Jesus told. We're not going to read because we have a short time. Praise the name of Jesus. When Jesus was teaching, he taught in parables. But when I stand on the parable that talks about the kingdom of God, I'll brief it. There's a word that Jesus said to people who can go into the kingdom of God before us. Things that people that commit sins and very detestable sins. But if we don't watch carefully, they can enter the kingdom of God before us. You already understand. I'm not going to explain too much. But the parable that talk about the kingdom of God. In Matthew 13, verse 18 until 23, it talks about the parable of the sower. So that parable, it shows people have freedom to decide to accept or to reject the gospel. Many rejected. Those who accepted, they grow spiritually. And that's why, as you go to preach, and nobody wants to repent because they have decided, they have rejected it. But there are others who may accept it. That's what the parable, this parable means. I did not read it. It talks about the seeds of the car, in the rocks and others in the good soil. And then they grow. The other parable, it's in Matthew again. That same chapter verse. It's about the seed and the weeds.
Yes.
It shows that the earth of now, those who belong to the kingdom of God, they live with people who neglect the kingdom of God. But on the judgment day,
when
the kingdom of God will be revealed, those who believe will be saved, the rest will be condemned. Praise the Lord. I know you understood those things.
Matthew 13,
31-33. There is a parable about the
master
seed. Praise the Lord.
The yeast.
A yeast, sorry. Thank you. It shows that kingdom that has a small beginning, but one day you have authority and power on the whole earth. There is another parable that cannot miss. The parable about the gold and
nusome basi Matayo chokatine nakane kwabonye mchenjuru. Matayo chini na gata tu inena kane na gata anda tu wasoma wanye kwa vokuvion.
14.
Matayo chini na gata tu inena kane chini na gata anda tu imajambo yabone.
This is the parable of the hidden treasure and the pearl. Okay.
Yeah, so
the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field. Praise the Lord.
So
what that parable means, the parable about the treasure and the pearl, it reveals when somebody understands clearly the things of the kingdom of God, and they understand that the kingdom of God is important, they do anything possible to enter.
But
the one who does not understand, no matter what you say, it's as if you're pouring water on the
wall.
It doesn't make sense. You might even get angry saying they don't understand.
Truth.
But the one who understands, they will take their offering with all their hearts. If the one who understands, they do a rejoicing. But the one who does not understand, you will see they are in sin.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
It will be like a pendulum, sorry, not still.
Andi kukurangiza.
I'm almost finishing.
Ariko kandi uburwa bw'Imana nyine.
But again, in that kingdom of God, even if I can speak in the church, those who believe they are in the kingdom of God, there's two groups. There is the truth and the liar. Who tells me? There is a parable I'm going to finish. The parable about the net.
It's in
Matthew
13.
Verse
13.
verse.
So what
is this? So the parable of the net. Once again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was let down into the lake and caught all kinds of fish. When it was full, the fishermen pulled it up on the shore. Then they sat down and collected the good fish in baskets, but threw the bad away. This is how it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come and separate the wicked from the righteous. Go to
50.
Praise the Lord. This parable, it shows that on the judgment day, at the end of the age,
hazuba gutandukanya,
there will be separation,
ababi,
the wicked,
n'abeza,
and the righteous.
Nimba ndiko ndavuga ubutumwa,
if I am preaching,
nkaba ndi umubeshi natunga,
and I'm lying, I'm not righteous.
Uwo munsi izogaragara.
That time you will be all this, will be revealed.
Nimba uri muri rishengero,
if you are in this church,
ukaba udakora ibyitonderwa byose,
and you don't obey the command,
ukora ibyo ugombye gusa,
you do whatever you want. That time will be manifested. Praise the Lord. That's why I said, among those who tell themselves they belong to the kingdom of God, they are in two groups. There is those who are in truth and others who are lying. And that's not work of
mankind
to say this one is in truth and this one is not. What we do as servants of God, we speak the word of God. Boldly we speak all the truth. Those who want to believe it and those who want to reject it. Because of our eyes,
our eyes are disappointed.
You may see somebody who is good, but in their heart there's nothing. That's what the hypocrites do. The hypocrites will greet you well when they hate you. The hypocrites will give you stories and they tell you those who hate you. And then when you leave, they'll talk about you. Praise the Lord. But that day will be revealed. Even the one who gives an offering, who wants people to see him, when it's not from the heart, we don't know that. But God knows it. Even the one that helps somebody so that it can be shown on TV, we don't know that. But God knows that. Praise the Lord. I testify there is God. And the judgment is near. The judgment is not far away. Don't think Jesus is delaying. He will come. And he's almost here. Don't think there's a long time left. Don't seek for the earthly things. You need to seek for these things. For those who don't seek for these things will be put to shame on that day. They will be put to shame. They used to be singers. When they used to preach. When they used to pray. When they used to fast. We need to uproot all sin. And when we repent, let's not put excuses on
someone
else. Let's take the blame on us.
What we are against,
that we have been tempted and we were overcome. Do you think here, me, I don't get tempted? I get tempted just like other people. But what I need is to overcome. Even you are not getting tempted. I know it well. When I see somebody who has
flesh,
this body that we wear, I know temptation is not far off. I only wait for the time to
overcome.
Praise the name of Jesus. As we finish, this teaching that I was on, the things that I would advise you to understand in this teaching. Seek, understand the importance of entering into the kingdom of God. And understand that even though we are in the kingdom of God now, study and understand that we will enter it. Even though we are in it now, it's not all put together. It's not all.
Over.
We have no
reach.
When we reach to heaven, that's when everything will be complete. The reason.
Internalize,
here we are in it. When we die in the body, spiritually we are still alive. Do you believe that? So which means study it and understand it. So that when you are tempted, you will know that you have faith and hope that you enter heaven. Yes, the body will get sick and other things. The body will be saved or
not.
The bodies are not saved yet. We are still getting sick. The pastors get sick. Even the teachers get sick. Even the evangelists get sick. Even the intercessors get sick. You think I'm lying? Do not lose your faith saying that I am sick. When the flesh dies, the spirit is living. Study well all the parables that talk about the kingdom of God. Ask the servants of God how the kingdom of God is observed. Another thing you need to study and learn. Learn to discern, to separate the kingdom of God
and
the church of God is two separate. Two different things. But I cannot talk about
it.
The servant of God talked about it in the morning. God will come and capture from different churches the people who belong in the kingdom of God I'm talking about. Even if they close the churches, the one who's in it will not leave. Are you understanding
me?
The word of God commands us to unite together.
If
there is somebody who prays the home and say,
I don't support this kind of thing.
You need to unite and get to fellowship with others. The Bible says, as you see the day drawing close, continue to gather together. I believe it's in the Bible. If you see other people as if they are
with
you, and you cannot unite, get together with them, that word will condemn you on that
day.
But if they close and they deny people, they stop people from having fellowship together, then you pray home. Even though we gather together, we still pray home.
Do
you think after here we don't pray home? So if you keep praying home, when you already were doing it, so what's the difference? What are you changing? To pray home is good. For those God who have God that
allows
you to pray with your wife and children, that's very wonderful. But that's not enough. It's important for the whole family to come in the church and we pray together, so that all the gifts that are here can bless us. The gifts that you have, you don't have all the gifts. You need to come from your home. If you sing, if you pray, maybe you don't see revelation. Do you think all of you here you receive revelation? All of these
night,
did you all dream? But there's someone who had visions or dreams. So we need to hear what those people dreamt. If God gave them dreams or visions, and me, I know how to discern
malaria.
Malaria. There are some who dream because of malaria or because they
are
tired. And then they dream. I know how to discern those
things.
If it's God who sent that dream, and you tell me that dream, I say, you're lucky. You see, God, please give us good. Even Satan will come. So if you were to stand here and say what God has shown you, you need to ask the servant of God to testify first.
And say that.
If you don't have the spirit to discern, to distinguish,
yani malaria,
say this malaria, or was I tired? Praise the name of Jesus. May God bless you. Now let us stand up. Let's sing one song. Let those who want to repent will come forward. And the servant of God will come forward and say the following.
Gitandara Shemala Rekangu Ungineko.
I don't like to take a long time of calling. That song, the one who wants to repent, the one who wants to put their house in order of their house, there is the martyr. Even the one who sleeps, if they want the Holy Spirit, you come. So to save the time, you save your life.
How is the
if there is no one, there's nobody who wants to repent, nobody will sing, nobody wants the power of the Spirit, if everything is all well, we pray the prayers to thank God. But if there's anyone, you should not be ashamed. I testify God is here, which the Bible says, where two or three gather in the name of Jesus, that's where he is. So me, I like to be quick. There I was meant to give the time to the one to do everything. So now he asked the one on the program to tell us the following.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Who are here to put their hearts in order?